worship choir of Bellevue Baptist Church invites you to discover why Jesus came down from his glory.
Thank you.
simply means praise God. We praise Him for the light ever shining from the stable in Bethlehem, the light that pierces brilliantly across every corner of the earth. And how do we know? Because Christmas is celebrated all around the world. People from every nation, every city, and every village will be joyously singing the songs of Christmas. Every music style, every possible instrument will herald the news that Jesus is born. From the bagpipes of Scotland, to the djembe of West Africa, from the sitar of Calcutta, to the steel drums of Jamaica. Child were the hands of God reaching out to each of our hearts. beyond our ability to comprehend, the Creator is now a part of creation. He who is larger than all the galaxies and beyond, now housed in and limited to a human body. He emptied himself of his glory and journeyed from eternity to Bethlehem. There is no way for us to imagine what that must have been like.
Father of glory revealed his Son, the Savior.
stand with us and sing.
Thank you.
endearing. These familiar melodies from distant worlds somehow connect us together and cause our minds to flood with all kinds of memories and feelings. When we live in a world of ever-changing trends and passing fads, why would the first few notes of a little ancient carol from Germany or England or France warm our hearts and cause us to smile inside as the melody lingers? Many of us never give any thought to how our most beloved Christmas carols ever got started. Songs that have been sung around the world about the wondrous birth of Jesus for hundreds of years. Can you think of any other person in history who has been immortalized, esteemed, and revered so much in music? We have found songs regarding the birth of Christ that have been dated back to the 4th century. I invite you to step back in time to a small country church in France. The year is 1760. As you sit with your family on a wintry Christmas Eve, you just might hear something like this.
When the men of golden days give the kings of kings their praise, they have pipes on which to play, toodaloo, pa-da-pa-da-da. They have drums on which to play for a joyful Christmas Day. Will you bring your little drum? Come and get your five. Thank you.
time of the year, when family and friends get together to reminisce of days gone by, to laugh, to love, to eat, to give gifts to one another, and maybe attend a Christmas performance or a candlelight service. Those of us who have grown up in church have watched the reenactments of the Christmas story change quite a bit over the years. We've gone from homemade costumes and props to wonderfully built sets and historically accurate clothing. You remember when you were a kid and you raided your dad's closet for a striped bathrobe so you could play a shepherd? You put a 6-foot bathrobe on a 4-foot body? Remember wearing a paper crown covered in glitter to play one of the wise men? Or how even the most active, giggly girls seemed to have a calmness about them as they poked their heads through the cut-out holes of their mother's white sheets and stuck in a coat hanger down their backs trimmed in silver or gold tinsel for their lopsided halos. And borrowing someone's baby doll to represent Jesus. But everyone young and old in the room seemed to know who the makeshift manger really held and what truly mattered. That 2,000 years ago, heaven came to earth, deity put on the robe of humanity. May the story of the birth of Jesus never become so familiar that it no longer moves or amazes us. On a night emblazoned by a magnificent star, a child was born like no child ever before, or since, or ever will be again. The birth of Jesus Christ is the single most important event in the history of the world. It's the crucial point of humanity, for all history up until that time moves toward it, and all history since that time moves away from it, marking his arrival at the very crossroads of time. The world acknowledges this, for it sets his calendar by his birth. Christ coming down from his glory changed everything. All the kings of the earth, all the great and powerful leaders put together, have not affected the world like this child called Jesus. And mankind knows that. In fact, they're busy right now celebrating it. They know the name of the one who was born on Christmas Day. People around the world know where he was born. They even know the approximate time when it all took place. Most of them can even tell you about the various characters in the Christmas story. Although millions of people know who, when, where, and what took place, the vast majority of them still miss the meaning of Christmas. The real story of Christmas is why he came. Why Bethlehem? Why a manger? Why shepherds? Why wise men? Why would God become a man?
Thank you.
for those weary from the storms of life, for those who will face this Christmas with one last loved one around the tree. We can take comfort, we can find strength, we can rest in and rejoice knowing that Bethlehem shouts, "We are loved."
Singing about this morning.
We have all the hope in the world. We have all the joy in the world. We have the promise of forgiveness of sins and everlasting life because God the Son left his throne in heaven, born of a virgin into this world, lived among us, experienced everything we experience, died on the cross, rose again, that we might have this hope and forgiveness of sins. We come this time every year to celebrate because that is when the one who saved us entered into this world in such miraculous fashion. We have to do this. Our hearts would burst if we didn't do something like this. Because of all the good God has done for us. Now that if you have this one who came in such a humble way, born of a virgin, born and laid in a manger there in a little sleepy town called Bethlehem, if your hope and trust and faith is in him, Jesus Christ, and what he did on the cross, and what he did by rising from the dead, you now have the Savior. You now have the salvation that he brought. He is the Savior. He's the only Savior we've ever been given. He's the only Savior we ever will be given. He's just waiting for you. Just waiting for you to do what the shepherds and the wise men did. Come to him. Bow down before him. Give him your heart. Give him your faith. Give him your trust. Let him save you. Ask him, Lord, please wash my sins away. Please forgive me. This one who came into Bethlehem can do all of this for you if you'll just come to faith in him. He went to that cross on Calvary around the age of 33. He went there and paid the penalty for my sins. He went there and paid the penalty for your sins. And they put him in a tomb. On the third day later, he rose from the dead. He's alive today. He's come right here. His spirit's right here. Just waiting for you. I want you to come up after the worship service. Come find me. There'll not be a formal invitation, but come and find me. I'll be right there at that back door if you want to come and talk to me about putting your faith and trust in Jesus Christ and being saved by his grace and faith in Christ Jesus. Our choir's going to come now and sing, I guess, the most famous, most well-known testimony and song, the Hallelujah Chorus by George Frideric Handel himself. And then we'll come back for just a word of a brief announcement there. Let these words reign supreme in your hearts. He is the Lord God omnipotent, and he reigneth as King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Back to the earliest days when this piece of music has been performed, everyone was so moved in its first performance that they stood, even Queen Victoria herself. And ever since then, people have been standing. Would you stand with me as the choir sings to us, Hallelujah.